Well, Reed got a coon.
First trap of the morning.
Nice.
Good start.
Yeah, I caught one too.
I heard.
Well, got a mink on a foothold. Definitely muskrat. Remember what you said? There's muskrat. There's mink.
That's a baby.
Yeah.
What's up, guy?
You guys blind trail set. Traps?
Blind trail set. Foothold.
First rat of the year.
Nice. Good size.
I was hoping to pick up a mink in there.
Yeah.
That's the muskrat instead. That's a big one now.
Yeah, it is.
That's the first one you stopped at. Nice size. Got your ear caught.
Did it have it by the body tooth?
Yeah.
Not by the feet at all?
No, it had it by the leg.
Oh, yeah.
It's a nice rat. There, that's what a muskrat looks like.
Right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, Johnny pulled it up on pictures last night.
Brandon's from Florida, so you don't know what this stuff looks like.
I had no idea what a muskrat looked like.
Well, I'm from Pennsylvania, and I didn't know what one looked like. So, I mean, there.
Well, it's rifle season. I got my buck. It's really warm out. Reed and I put some coon traps out yesterday. And we bought Duke, I believe they're called coon cuffs. And I'm getting to my first two. Dad and I hunted this morning. Saw a little buck and a couple does, but no luck. And I'm down here checking my first two traps, and I doubled on the coon cuffs down here. So I'm gonna take you down here and show you what I got. He's in there pretty deep. The nice thing about these, I can't chew their foot off. There's the first one. And then I have another trap right up here. And he actually, the wire is wrapped around a tree, and he's halfway up the tree with it. Not halfway, but a couple feet. First two traps, two coon. Just set out a little fish oil for an attractant, and then a marshmallow down the coon cuffs. So I'm going to take care of these and go check my next ones.
All right, I'm going to do today, show you how we run these Duke dog-proof traps. We caught 54 coon on them this year and haven't had a single pull out. You guys are in speed trapping. I'll show you how we rig them. All we have is a piece of cable, big loop in one side and a little loop in the other. I'll show you how easy this is. Run it through there. Run your big loop through the little loop. So it's like that. You can already have these rigged up with marshmallows stuffed in them. Come to a tree, along a stream, or anywhere you think can. So if you just wrap these around, set your coon cuff, put it through your big loop. It's tight, in the ground it goes, spread some fish oil. 30 seconds, if not less, if you already have these things rigged up. And just take it out of the tree, same exact way. Move on to the next spot. Easy.
Well, here's another raccoon. 2 days in a row I've caught coon out of this set. All I got's that coon cuff with wire wrapped all the way around the tree so you can spin around the tree. Marshmallow in the cuff and a little fish oil sprinkled around. Well, day three of the coon trap's out during rifle season, and this trap here with the coon cuffs, 3 for 3. 3 nights, 3 coon. I haven't caught a big coon out of them yet, though. Shane has. I don't know if you got film of it or not. But up there. Yeah, it doesn't look like anything bothered that one last night.
Well, here we are with ribs this morning. came along with them on a strapping excursion. I think we have a coon down here in this fox set. High winds today, so we're just gonna get this coon and then get out of here. There it is.
Talking to Reed, he caught a couple coon last night. Checked them before work. We got some traps to check yet, so might be a whole truck bed full of them.
Well, just pulled up to another trap here.
I don't know, the coon may or may not have moved last night, I'm not sure.
Rube has one up here.
Third one of the day.
Reed caught three and a possum, so six coon and a possum today.
It's a pretty big culvert, and he's laying right in the middle of it. But already took care of him, and now I gotta go up in there and get him, try to stay dry. So, keep it rolling, Ted, just in case I fall in. What do you think?
Go for it. Why? If you're having trouble getting it, I guarantee I ain't gonna be able to get it.
Yeah, that was the first one of the day. I'm just about done checking all my traps, but this guy was dabbling inside this culvert right here, and I had leg hold in there with a drag, and he didn't make it real far. So first one of the day. Caught one yesterday also, but didn't have the camera with me.
Well, we went out and set beaver traps yesterday. I caught my very first beaver ever. The trap probably weighs about 2 pounds. I'd say upper 20s in weight wise. Using the Bridger number 4, caught it right in the front leg right there.
So, last night rained all day yesterday. And I'm supposed to get snow, but it kind of held off just to a light dusting that we have now. So I'm gonna get him and keep checking traps. Well, out checking a trap line this morning, and I finally caught something that I really did not want to catch. Not real excited about it because it's gonna be a major pain in the butt, but I'll show you. Set this fox set yesterday. And sure enough, there's my first skunk I gotta deal with.
Well, checking a trap right there. Another day on the line, season's winding down. Still trying to catch our first fox, hasn't happened. Got Reed with me, and we're just gonna enjoy the Saturday morning checking traps.
While we're out checking traps, we got a flock of jakes, and there's a cream-colored hen in there.
I believe these ones might be tame.
You shouldn't have said that.
Well, I think they'll figure it out. Well, I have a coon set here, marshmallow and fish oil on the tree, and I've never seen this before. It's the first time I ever caught one, and it is huge. Check this thing out.
A weasel.
That's a first for me. I've never even seen one really before, but.
That's cool.
Yeah.
You never know what you're gonna catch trapping.
That's right. Well, there he is. First one ever. All they had was a little set right on top of the little bump right there. And a little clump of grass. Or hay with the scent on it. Down here in the snow, they always wanted to come up onto that bump. First fox. Nice gray. Nice looking gray.
Well, out here trapping this morning, it's like 4:30 in the morning. Had to get up before work, gotta be at work at 6, so caught a coon this morning in a Duke DP, dog proof trap. To take care of this thing and then reset my trap, get ready for work.
Well, it's Friday morning. Reed and I are gonna head up the Erie Steelhead fishing here in a bit. Gotta check our traps first. I got a couple coon cuffs out down here and then a flat set right here along this bridge.
There he is. Yeah. I don't know if you can see it or not.
I guess you can,
but I guess that coon got caught both front paws.
Well, caught another coon this morning. It's a Saturday. It must be the 4th. This is either my 3rd or 4th catch this week out of that exact trap there. So I gotta get going here. I gotta go help my aunt move. So I'm running a little bit behind. So I'm gonna go take care of this coon and probably won't even reset the trap right now. I'll have to do it later on today.
Up to 68 now for the year, so.
And then we all have all of our unsets we gotta check in the morning also.
Yeah.
If anyone was ever to bet anything in their entire life, it would be that if there is a burdock bush anywhere around, Toth will find it. That's a guaranteed. There could be one within 1 square mile.
100 yards from me, I'll have more in there.
And he'll find it, no matter where it's at. Steelhead fishing, how do you get on your steelhead fishing? I have no idea. He had burdocks on him. So, if you're ever going to make a bet, bet that Toth will find a burdock.
Well, Shane caught his very first coyote. Look at that. Isn't that awesome? Hold on here, we'll get some good pictures of him. Let's just get some good video. He ain't going anywhere.
I think I got him in the pad pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go off to him. Hey, buddy. Hey. Hey. Just go easy, go easy, go easy.
He ain't going anywhere.
All right, stop. I'm gonna shoot it.
Okay, hold on. Let me just get a little bit of video here.
There we go.
Let me get... Yep, first coyote.
You good, Johnny?
Okay. Pretty good.
Yeah!
Good job.
First coyote, baby.
Good job.
Right there, using a Bridger 165. Modified. Had him right.
Yes, sir.
Right across the toes. Well, what I did is I got this old log and I had it setting up like this. And I had a pheasant wing tucked underneath the limb there. It had hay stacked up on it. This was probably back here a little bit. had a trap bedded right here. Trap bedded here. What I did was just covered everything up. Give it some eye peel because, well, whenever I set this, there was snow. That was the only thing on the snow, like a hay set. You can see the pheasant laying around like that. And I was telling these guys, I'm gonna catch a coyote. Last day of season, I caught a coyote. Look at the color.
Yeah, pretty colored. Hold his head up there. That's really nice. You said it was a female?
Yep, female.
Hold him up there. Yes, sir.